Hello student, today we start the BSc first year paper first, that is ether taxonomy and ecological adaptation. BSc first year fishery science paper first, ether taxonomy and ecological adaptation. Already I told that every paper have the four units, right? Today we start paper first, unit number one. That is scope and importance of fishery science. Scope and importance of fishery science. Right? Before that, some little bit introduction of fishery science. What is meant by the fishery science? Fish have the great significance in life of mankind because it is a valuable food fish. It is a easily digestible. It gives the revenue to the government also. Means fish have the great significance in the life of mankind, being an important natural source of protein. It gives the proteins, minerals, carbohydrate, vitamins A and vitamins D. That's why fish is very useful, very beneficial to the human beings. And some product is also sell in the market, national and international level. Because the some marine water fishes give the product, that is vitamins A and vitamin D. Some liver oils, some body oils contains vitamins to the human being, which is beneficial for the eye, skin and other things. It means that it is the great significance of fish to the human beings. This is about the basic concept of fish, right? Then here mention about the definition. Means what is meant by fish? In exam, they ask for the purpose of 1 mark. First of all, definition of fish. Fish is a cold-blooded. Fish is a cold-blooded. What is meant by cold-blooded? The body can adjust the surrounding atmosphere called the cold-blooded. Human beings is not a cold-blooded, they are the warm-blooded, right? Then vertebrate means vertebral column is present. Aquatic animal, respiration by means of gills. Human being respiration by means of lungs, but the fishes respiration by means of gills. Locomotion by means of fins. This is the special point. Respiration by means of gills. Locomotion by means of fins. Spindle or board shape. How it is? Fish spindle or board shape. This is the definition of fish. Fish is a cold-blooded, vertebrate, aquatic animal. Respiration by means of gills. Locomotion by means of fins. Spindle or board shape called the fish. This is the definition of fish. Very simple for the purpose of 1 mark. Right? But some scientist is studied first time that how it is, how can we identify, they identify in 1705. The scientist, Father Peter, and one from the scientist from India, that is the Hora, 1896. 8 December 1896, they found that, they observed that about the identification of fish. Okay, then some point of view about the fish. It is a vertebrate, already I told in the definition, have the jaws in the mouth, some fishes have the jaw, some fishes don't have the jaw. Cold-blooded, breathe by means of gills, live in water. Special point is that 36,000 species are present in the world. Within that, 40% of total vertebrate are present. Right? Then fishes have the different size, different shape and different habit. Some are the carnivorous, some are the herbivorous and some are the predator fishes. It is depend upon the fish and it is depend upon the size, about length and shape. One of the large fish the world, that is the shark, you know, very well, already you are observing the National Geography and other channels. 20 meters in length, and fish live in all seas, river, lake, reservoirs. Fishes have the different habit. Some fishes are live in water, some fishes are in lake, reservoirs, canals and tanks. Reservoir means the pani, the water is storage. That is in our Nanded Vishnupuri Dam, Aurangabad, Jayakwadi. All are the nothing but the reservoirs. Lake, rivers, canals and tanks. Then some fishes are habiting fresh water, routine regularly we use in a house, that is the fresh water, drinking water. Brackish water, what is mean by the brackish water? Some fishes are found in the brackish water. Brackish water means combination of fresh water and marine water. The premises is called the brackish water. And sea water, you know very well in the Mumbai, Ratnagiri, all are the in sea water. Some fishes live in fresh water, some fish in brackish water, and some fishes in the sea water. Then economically important. What is the purpose? What is how it is the economically important benefit for the person or the human being or the other marketable value? One thing is that fish liver are the main source of vitamins A and D. With the help of this, the contents are sale as a medicine in the market for national and international level also. Body oil is also one of the important. The industries are used the body oil of fish. Then one of the important thing, that is the aquarium. Aquarium fishes are present in the aquarium. Aquarium is also important for the economically for marketable persons. Some valuable food fish from the fresh water, that is Channa and Katla. It is very important and valuable food fish, highly demanded. And in the example of marine water, that is mackerel and pomfret. More and more fishes, for as our syllabus, I am giving the two examples from the fresh water and two examples from the marine water. Fresh water, that is Channa and Katla. Marine water from the mackerel and the pomfret. Then this is the a figure of fish. Some point of view I will mention, that is the in definition what we found, that is the locomotion by means of fins. Here the fins, this is the caudal fin, this is the dorsal fin. Two dorsal fin are present, this is the caudal fin for the purpose of locomotion. This is the anal fin and this is the pelvic fin. What are the function we will see in the next video. Dorsal fin, caudal fin, anal fin and the pelvic fin. This is the structure of fish, right? And commonly culture fish, which type of fish are cultured in the areas? Important two things is that, number one, that is the IMC. But what is meant by IMC? IMC means Indian Major Carps. The sentence gives the mention, that is the Indian means the fishes belonging from the India. Which are they? Katla, Rohu, Mriga. Here I will mention Katla, Rohu, Mriga. One point of this, that Indian major carps. Carps means what? The definition of carps means toothless mouth. They don't have the tooth. Called the carp. Which one are carp? Katla, Rohu, Mriga. More and more fishes, but our syllabus, the three fishes is very important, which belonging from the Indian major carp, which belonging from the common culture in the areas. Next one, that is the exotic carp. What is meant by exotic carp? Exotic carp means those fishes which belonging from the foreign country, which are introduced in India for the commercial purpose. Which are they? Silver carp, grass carp and common carp. One point of this, that we are mentioned, that is the carp. Already I told that carp means toothless mouth, called the carp. The example, that is Katla, Rohu, Mriga, which are belonging from the India. Foreign country, which are belonging from the foreign country, which are they? Silver carp, grass carp and the common carp. And some are the predator fishes. Which are they? Channa and Mr. Singala. It is also important, which is also commonly cultured in areas. Right. Within that, some ponds and some lake, some people are culture freshwater prawns, and some are which are the near in the seawater, they can culture the prawn. Pinnate means one type of prawns, Pinnate indicus and Pinnis monodon. Okay, all are culture in ponds and lake for the purpose of economically beneficial for the person. Okay, thank you.